There are some pretty crazy theories out there, but are they true? To be honest, I'm inclined to say no, but who knows, they might be. From secret stargates to the truth of evolution, these are five scary theories that might be true. Before we begin, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification bell for more amazing videos every day. That being said, let's begin.
Huh?
Number 5. Saved by the Bell was a vehicle for the Illuminati. Before we get started, I think it's best that I point out, I personally think every theory I'm about to discuss is boiling hot nonsense. But the thing is, there are plenty of people out there who believe in each of these, and people believe some crazy things. Some people think the British royal family are secretly lizard monsters. Others believe there's no moon. Let's explore five of the scariest and see if we think there's even the slightest chance each one might be real. We start with a goofy one, but one that would be terrifying if true. Saved by the Bell was a vehicle for the Illuminati. One of the best 90s shows was Saved by the Bell, which followed a group of teenagers as they strolled through high school in a completely unrealistic realm, yet the plotline and theme song claim they deal with the typical struggles of a high school student. Nonetheless, the show was a good time if you were into it back then, meaning you're probably an 80s baby. But there's a growing fan theory that the entire show was all just a dream in Zach Morris's head. It's a fun theory. It would certainly explain why Zach's life was so perfect and why you could freeze time and talk to camera for some reason. But how does this fun fan theory link the show to the Illuminati? Well, there's a whole website dedicated to exploring the scary theory, and let me tell you, as someone who had to research it for the sake of this video, it is an in-depth website. That's 48 solid hours of reading I'll never get back. We've not got time here in this video to go into full detail, so if you're interested, research it for yourself. But here's the selected highlights behind their reasoning. Evidence A. The main character, Zach Morris, graduates with an SAT score of 1502, considered average, and then gets accepted to none other than Yale University, home of the Illuminati secret society, Skull and Bones. Some claim that he wouldn't have been able to get into Yale with that low of an SAT score. Mark Paul Gosselaar plays Zach Morris, and some theorists claim that he and Paul Walker are one and the same. Evidence B. The cover for the soundtrack album apparently has three sixes hidden in it. And we all know how shifty three sixes is. Can you see them? If you want to explore the conspiracy theory in full, we suggest you do. Somebody's really put their work into this one. Now it's time for the star topic. So, we recently found this photo online, and as I'm sure you can tell from looking at it yourself, it's got everybody here at the finest HQ talking. Now, we don't know the context of where the photo came from, but as you can see, it's some kind of image showing the classic ape-to-human evolutionary line. But notably, there's an extra stage included that isn't included in the traditional lineup. What is this picture? Is it merely a hypothesis by somebody who thinks evolution may be more complex than we initially thought, or is this genuinely how evolution went down? The creature at the start has a real xenomorph vibe, and we can't figure out what's being implied here. Does the original artist think aliens evolved into apes that became humans? If so, that has some pretty serious connotations for the future of mankind. And for the past of mankind. Remember to comment down below with the hashtag star topic, and we will pin the comment that best explains what's being shown on this image. With that said, let's keep things moving. Number 4. Jay-Z is a time-traveling vampire. On the subject of the possibly real but possibly not secret organization that rules the world, there are vast regions of the internet devoted to explaining why Jay-Z is part of the Illuminati. Both him and his wife Beyoncé have been linked with the group for a significant amount of time. But the theories regarding Jay-Z took an interesting turn when this photo rocked on up. The picture was taken in New York in 1939, and as you can see, Jay-Z appears to be present. Now, either that's not Jay-Z in the photo and it's merely somebody who looks like him, or Mr. Z is significantly older than he looks. Some have suggested that this is Jay-Z and that the rapper is a time traveler. Others have suggested that this is Jay-Z and the rapper is a vampire. Others have suggested that he is maybe both. Jay-Z isn't exactly the first A-lister to rock on up in unexpected places, though. Daniel Radcliffe, perhaps best known for not being Elijah Wood, has been spotted in a vast array of different time periods. It's even been discussed on a couple of different celebrity chat shows. To the best of our ability, though, we can't find any conspiracy theories linking the man who was once Potter with the Illuminati, time travel, or vampirism. So there must be something really striking about that one photo of Jay-Z that has captured the imagination of conspiracy theorists in the way it has. What do you think? Is Jay-Z a time traveler? Is he a member of the Illuminati? Is he a vampire? All of the above? Or is the man in the photo merely a random nobody from the past who just so happens to look like Mr. Knowles? Wanna know my theory? I think Jay-Z is deliberately spreading the false rumor that he is a time-traveling vampire to try and distract people from figuring out that it's actually Radcliffe who is the real time-traveling vampire. You heard it here first, folks. Number 3. Barack Obama could control the weather. But while Jay-Z might have the power to travel in time, he's not the only celebrity rumored to have special abilities. Oh no. During both his terms, it was alleged that President Obama deliberately manipulated the weather to deflect attention away from the White House in times of scandal. In May 2013, after a mile-wide tornado struck Moore, Oklahoma and killed 24 people, right-leaning broadcasters and internet truthers suggested the US Air Force had caused the disaster on purpose to distract from a series of governmental controversies. I mean, if it's true, and Mr. Obama can control the weather, it's safe to assume he's responsible for the gusts of wind that keep messing up Trump's hair, right? But seriously, this is an actual theory that has an awful lot of people behind it. They just think there was too much convenient bad weather during Barack's time in office. Hyperclimate astrologist Seth Borenstein was even forced to comment on the theory, saying, scientifically, the president doesn't have control of day-to-day weather. While his policies can lessen or worsen future projected global warming on a large scale, they cannot do anything about Washington's daily temperature. So, what do you think? Could Barack Obama control the weather? Can he still do it now? And if so, do you think he used his powers for good or for evil? And does he continue to use them now that he's no longer in office? And how does he do it? So many questions! Number 2. Saddam Hussein had a Stargate. The theory that the Second Gulf War was waged in order to close a Stargate owned by Saddam Hussein, thus preserving the ambitions of the New World Order and preventing an alien invasion of Earth, is not exactly widespread. But there is a website dedicated to it, so clearly somebody takes it seriously. For those of you not in the know, according to Hollywood, Stargates are ancient alien devices that can allow any user to teleport instantaneously to another gate, no matter the distance, which, when you think about it, is super duper cool. To begin, we're gonna need to go way back in time and talk about the Sumerians, who lived in ancient Mesopotamia, an area that covers a portion of modern-day Iraq. The Sumerians were one of the first civilizations in existence around 3000 BC, and for a time worshipped the Anunnaki, their deities. But what if they weren't gods? What if they were aliens? So, without getting too deep into the marsh, the theory, which comes from writers like Zechariah Sitchin, posits that the Anunnaki were not gods, but extraterrestrials that came and bestowed technology upon the Sumerians. This tech is what made their society so advanced at the time. Essentially, the Iraq War Stargate theory pushes and narrows this idea a little further, saying one of the technologies that were gifted upon the Sumerians were stargates, and their positioning was one of the major reasons for the years of strife in the Middle East. According to an individual called Mahmoud al-Diwaniyahi, the alien stargate may have been hidden away in one of several locations. Some possible locations include A. An ancient crypt beneath the Sumerian ziggurat or pyramid of Dur-Kurigalzu near Baghdad. B. The so-called Dark Ziggurat of Enzu, located in the Az-Zab-Az-Segir or Little Zab River Valley, which once was the lair of Gimil-Ishbi, a Sumerian sorcerer of 3000 BC. C. Beneath the ancient fortress of Kalat-i-Jalundi near Zarzi in the Little Zab River Valley, north of Mosul. D. Saddam's reputed underground base in Al-Uja, 3 kilometers or 2 miles north of Tikrit, which was built for him by the Zarzi aliens, extraterrestrials whose UFO crashed in Iraq in December 1998 and who were given sanctuary in Zarzi by Saddam. And here I was thinking stargates weren't real. Honestly, I feel like such a fool. The website doesn't seem to suggest why they think Hussein had a stargate, so I guess we'll just have to take their word for it. If Saddam did have a stargate, the worrying question is, who has it now? Did Western society successfully take it from him? And if so, what are they using it for? Did they sell it to Starbucks? Is that how the coffee chain has managed to spread its product across the world so fast in such a short amount of time? This isn't the only conspiracy theory about Saddam. Another, concerning the apparently still alive Elvis, claims that Saddam and Elvis ride around in a Shabria on the back of a giant scorpion. That is an actual thing that some real people believe. So, what do you think? Was Saddam Hussein once in possession of a stargate? Did he plan to use it to overthrow the universe? Is that why Western society went to war against him? Have they seized it? And if so, what have they done with it? Let us know what you think in the comments below. Number 1. I have no body. I am just a voice. Our final theory, one I've heard many people discuss, is that I may have no body, no corporeal form of any description, and may just be a voice. The evidence? Well, have any of you ever seen my body? Have any of you ever seen my face? Exactly. So, following the same train of logic that many conspiracy theorists use when they put together their theories, it seems safe to suggest that I have no body of any description and I am merely a voice, lacking any real physical form. I mean, it would certainly explain why I have no friends. Do you think any of these theories could be real? Or do you, like us, think they're all a bit silly? Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen right now. See you next time!